Dear all, in this video I will be discussing how to prepare PhD comprehensive viva. Let us have a brief checklist so that it will help you to prepare comprehensive viva well. First and the foremost, let's understand what is comprehensive viva. It varies from the university procedure, way of conduction, all the formality will be varied from university, depends on the university. However, let us define what is a comprehensive viva. It's a focused discussion giving you the opportunity to defend your PhD thesis in front of a doctoral committee or a panel of academic experts on the domain. Now, this is about comprehensive viva. What are the checklists you have to consider before preparing comprehensive viva? So, I listed out a few checklists that will really helpful for you for the preparation of comprehensive viva. The first preparation, what you are supposed to do is anticipate the viva questions. So go through your work, what you have done, and what are the things that have to be done, that has to be added in a future work. So you have to anticipate what are the expected questions. That's important. So next one is understand what's expected of you. Okay, so what you are supposed to do, what could be the expectation that you are supposed to mention, and what might be the expectation from the doctoral committee, that is also required. Another point is know your thesis inside out, in the sense you should have a deep understanding about the research work which you are going to carry out, or some work you might have done that you should have a good idea, that is required. Learn about your examiners' background and the work carried out by them. That's very important. If possible, please collect the research paper which they have published. Please go through that. Then definitely you will have a good idea what is the interested area in that particular committee. Focus on your contribution. What the works you have done that you are supposed to highlight. Plan towards the viva examination. That's also very essential. Your proper planning, that will really help you to defend the questions which is asking by them. How you can able to give a better answer. So these are the important checklist you need to follow. What could be the contents of presentation? Suppose you are preparing a presentation, better you can prepare a nice PPT or nice presentation such that you can highlight the works which you carried out and what are the future scope or what are the future work which is to be done. Let us have a flow of the content of presentation. Make sure that you have prepared the front page which includes the title of the thesis, then your name and details, then your supervisor name with the designation and the detail and the academic year. That has to be followed as per the university format. Next one is introduction. So what is the work, what is the background of the work, and what is the scenario of the work at the particular technology, or what is the importance of the work in this present scenario, that can be highlighted very clearly. Better add less number of words, you can speak it more. Another thing is very important, what about the literature review you have carried out about the previous work conducted by different authors. You can refer the standard journals and you can put up the name of the author with their paper and try to speak up what they have carried out and what is your contribution. At least 10 to 15 literature paper you can able to put up in the presentation. Another one is important thing, that is problem statement. It should be precise. Once anybody read the problem statement, they should know that these are things which is regarding the problem statement of the work and the research scholar is carrying out to get the proper solution. So problem statement should be precise and easily understand by everybody. Another one is objective. What are the major objective of the work? That has to be highlighted point by point. Then your methodology also need to be specified clearly. Afterwards your work, then what are the works you carried out, modeling, mathematical modeling you must have done. Then analysis, for example, comparing two methods, three methods, method A, method B, method C. You are doing the comparison of three methods by using the certain performance parameter. That also need to be highlighted in a tabular column. Remaining part of the research work in the form of future expansion or some work need to be extended. Such cases you have to mention it separately. Publications are very essential. You have to add the details of publication from the in the order of latest to latest. For example, 2020 you have published one paper, and you have to arrange it in the descending order. And you have to mention what are the workshop which are related to the title which you have attended in various organization. That also has to be entered in the descending order in the year. Okay. So these are the contents you need to take care. And don't forget to add the references paper. So how much reference paper you have mentioned, that need to be specified clearly. Okay. In that, author name should be there, title of the paper, volume, date of publication, all the points need to be added. So this is just an example. You can make use of the flow if you are comfortable. Hopefully the session will be useful, especially for research scholars. In this session I have discussed about the importance of comprehensive IVA and what are the contents of presentation you need to add. If you are having any queries, you can write in the comment box. I will definitely revert. So let me conclude the session. Finally, thank you.